Hello everyone, my name is Boko. Thank you for coming. Today we have a lesson called Should and Need. Download the free PDF for this lesson and many other lessons on my Ko-fi page. Subscribe to my YouTube channel and let's begin. Hajde da počnemo. Before we start, there is something you need to know. First, there are many posts and websites out there about Serbian grammar, about specifically should and need, with the wrong information. These verbs are specific and different from all the others, but there is only one correct way of using them, and that is what I'm going to show you today. If you see it any other way on different websites, on the internet, anywhere, it will be incorrect. I will show you the only correct way of using should and need. That's the first thing I want to tell you. The second thing, we are talking about Serbian only. You can call it the language, dialect, whatever. Talking about Serbian only. No Croatian. Croatian language has different rules for should and need. So please always have in mind these two things. Now we can start learning. What is actually very interesting is that should and need is one verb in Serbian. Trebati. So maybe we can start talking about should first. I'll try to separate it. So the verb trebati must be used as impersonal, only in the third person singular forms, only. Treba, trebalo bi, trebalo je for the past, when it appears with another verb. When it appears with another verb, it must be impersonal. That is should when translated into English. I should study too. Treba I ja da učim. You can never say trebam I ja da učim. That is completely incorrect in Serbian. It's correct in Croatian though, but it's not. It can never be correct in Serbian. Many people get this wrong. Many people teach my students wrong. You know, when they come to Serbia and then their neighbors, other people around them, then the native, the Serbians, don't know this. They don't use it correctly. So they would teach you wrong, you know? So be careful. You can never say this sentence. That is absolutely incorrect. So examples. You should go to school. Treba da ideš u školu. He should do his homework. Treba da uradi domaći. We should go. Treba da idemo. They should come today. Treba da dođu danas. Moving on. Treba and trebalo bi are interchangeable. You should go to school. Trebalo bi da ideš u školu. He should do his homework. Trebalo bi da uradi domaći. We should go. Trebalo bi da idemo. They should come today. Trebalo bi da dođu danas. Having said that, trebalo bi just goes better in some sentences where it means something like I think or probably. Everybody should be here. Trebalo bi da su svi tu. So I'm checking if the whole group is here, like all the 10 students. And I'm saying everybody should be here, like I think I saw everybody, you know? And then if you say treba da su svi tu, it's more of a critical sentence. Like I'm criticizing you because I saw that one or two of you are missing. So I'm saying treba da su svi tu. Like you should all be here, you know? Like what are you doing? So there's a little difference to it. You should be grounded. Trebalo bi da budete kažnjeni. I should have some money. Trebalo bi da imam nešto novca. past tense. You should have done it earlier. Trebalo je to ranije da uradiš. She should have helped too. Trebalo je i ona da pomogne. You should have thought with your own head. This is a Serbian saying. Trebalo je da misliš svojom glavom. This is where we stop. If we continue, we come to an example where we have nije trebalo or trebalo je with a plural subject, which is a touchy subject, and I would rather draw the line here. The thing is that even the Serbian language specialists or experts are saying this could not be said in a correct way. You know, the past tense and the plural subject, like we, Anna and I, like we should have come here earlier, because the subject would not match with this verb. You know, they would not match in numbers, because this is the third person singular, trebalo je. So I could keep talking about this, but as I said, let's move on. Let's recap. If the verb trebati appears with another verb, that's should in English, and that's always impersonal. I should, treba da. You should, treba da. He, she, it should, treba da. We should, treba da. You should, plural, treba da. They should, treba da. Now, we can move on to the need verb, or part. If there is no other verb in a sentence, the impersonal limitation does not apply anymore, so the verb trebati can be freely conjugated in all persons with two cases differing. Number one, the subject of the verb can be what is needed, like an object or a living being. Examples: I need longer nails. Trebaju mi duži ekseri. So basically you're using the dative structure, dativ padež, and then you're saying to me, trebaju mi duži ekseri. Mi is to me, and trebaju is they are needed, right? We didn't need his help. Nije nam trebala njegova pomoć. Like, his help was not needed to us. He needed a more experienced colleague. Trebao mu je iskusniji kolega. Number two, I mean, a different way of creating a sentence is that the subject can be the person or thing that needs something, in which case the verb trebati becomes transitive. For example, I need a new winter jacket. Trebam novu zimsku jaknu. We will need you. Trebaćemo vas. The academy needed professors. Akademija je trebala profesore. I think this is like a straightforward translation from English to Serbian, and it's probably like easier for you to comprehend, but it's kind of weird for us because we really love the dative constructions. Now, I will show you examples of same sentences in both first and second format. I need you, trebaš mi, or trebam te, right? So the first one, you are needed by me or to me, is something that we really like saying, is more common to us. And the second one is I need you, trebam te, which is more literal, as I said, but kind of sounds weird to us, to Serbian speakers. It's definitely correct, as you can see, but I'm just saying, out of these two, we really love the first one more. I needed the money. Trebao mi je novac. Trebao sam novac. Do you need anything? Da li vam treba nešto? Da li trebate nešto? I just want to say one more thing about this. Da li trebate nešto? Do you need anything? Like you cannot be needing something, you know? Something can be needed by you. You cannot be needing something. I mean, at least not in Serbian. It sounds so weird to say trebam jaknu, I need a jacket. You cannot, I mean, it's not an active thing that you can do, needing something, you know? So that's why it's so natural for us to say that the new jacket is needed by me, you know? You cannot be needing it in an active way. Additionally, instead of using need, you can use the adjective potreban. It's the same meaning. I need a jacket, treba mi jakna, potrebna mi je jakna. He needs new shoes, trebaju mu nove cipele, potrebne su mu nove cipele. I need help. Treba mi pomoć, potrebna mi je pomoć. Finally, you can hear English sentences like you need to come home, I need to tell you something, or they need to see this. But we cannot use the need form here because, as you remember, if you have treba and you have another verb in a sentence, it has to be should. That's the rule. It has to be impersonal. So you need to see, you need to do is basically impossible, technically, is impossible in Serbian. You can say it incorrectly, but that's it. So it comes down to the same thing, right? I mean, you're talking about the same thing, but technically, you have to say it a little differently. You cannot say it exactly like that. So you can say, you should come home. I should tell you something, or they should see this, right? Or maybe it would even be better using must in that case. Like you have to decide. I'm just saying, but you cannot say it identically to English. You can say you need to come home, treba da dođeš kući, moraš da dođeš kući. I need to tell you something, moram da ti kažem nešto. They should see this, moraju ovo da vide. So as I said, it seems even better if you use the must in this case. All right, thank you very much for watching. If you wish to have a live one-on-one lesson, you can find me on Italki. Also, improve your Serbian on the language learning app uTalk. Download free PDFs on my coffee page. Check out my socials. And don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Hvala, vidimo se, zdravo!